Welcome to our Good Friday worship service this evening. This evening we will be experiencing our service of shadows from the Office of Tenebrae. During the course of this service, we will be experiencing some readings, which will be followed by the extinguishing of candles. And the service will end in darkness as we contemplate time that Jesus spent in darkness at the end of Good Friday. Let us pray together. Lord, enter this space with us. Be with us. Embrace us. Don't leave us. As we experience the darkness Jesus took on for us and to glorify you. Amen.
If you could please rise for the call to worship. And take a look inside your bulletins and let us join together. We are gathering to recall the night when Jesus was betrayed. Are you ready to come to the feet of Christ, whose life was poured out for you?
By the grace of God, we are.
Can you watch while Jesus prays in the garden?
By the grace of God, we will.
Will you follow Jesus even into the night of betrayal?
By the grace of God, we will.
Then let us praise God even in the hours of darkness. Now please open your red hymnals to number 288. Were you there?
Thank you. I invite you to join with me in the unison prayer. Almighty God, we ask that you would be present with us, Lord, your children, for whom your Son, Jesus Christ, was willing to be betrayed into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
The shadow of betrayal. When evening came, Jesus was at the table with the 12. While they were eating, he said, "What I am about to tell you is true. One of you will hand me over to my enemies." The disciples became very sad. One after another, they began to say to him, "It's not I, Lord, is it?" Jesus replied, "The one who has dipped his hands into the bowl with me will hand me over. The Son of Man will go just as it is written about him. But how terrible it will be for the one who hands over the Son of Man. It would be better for him if he had never been born." Judas was the one who was going to hand him over. He said, "It's not I, Lord, is it?" Jesus answered, "Yes, it is you."
Shadow of desertion. Jesus told them, "This very night you will all turn away because of me. It is written that the Lord said, 'I will strike the shepherd down, then the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I rise from the dead, I will go ahead of you into Galilee." Peter replied, "All the others may turn away because of you, but I never will." "What I'm about to tell you is true," Jesus answered. "It will happen this very night. Before the rooster crows, you will say 3 times that you don't know me." But Peter said, "I may have to die with you, but I will never say I don't know you." And all the other disciples said the same thing.
The shadow of lethargy. Jesus and his disciples went to a place called Gethsemane. Jesus said to them, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him. He began to be very upset and troubled. "My soul is very sad. I feel close to death," he said to them. "Stay here, keep watch." He went a little farther, and then he fell to the ground and he prayed, "If possible, the hour might pass him by. Abba," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup of suffering away from me, but let what you want be done, not what I want." Abba means Father. Then he returned to the disciples and found them sleeping. "Simon," he said to Peter, "are you asleep? Couldn't you keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray, and then you won't fall into sin when you are tempted. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak." Once more, Jesus went away and prayed the same thing. Then he came back. Again, he found them sleeping. They couldn't keep their eyes open. They did not know what to say to him. Jesus returned a third time, and he said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Enough. The hour has come. Look, the Son of Man is about to be handed over to the sinners."
Why did it have to be a friend who chose to betray the Lord? Why did he use a kiss to show them that's not what a kiss is for? Only a friend can betray a friend. The strangers have nothing to gain. And only a friend comes close enough to ever cause so much pain.
The shadow of denial. Then the men arrested Jesus and led him away. They took him into the high priest's house. Peter followed from far away. They started a fire in the middle of the courtyard. Then they sat down together, and Peter sat down with them. A female servant saw him sitting there in the firelight. She looked closely at him. Then she said, "This man was with Jesus." But Peter said he had not been with him. "Woman, I don't know him," he said. A little later, someone else saw Peter. "You also are one of them," he said. "No," Peter replied, "I'm not." About an hour later, another person spoke up. "This fellow must have been with Jesus," he said. "He is from Galilee." Peter replied, "Man, I don't know what you're talking about." And just as he was speaking, the rooster crowed. The Lord turned and looked right at Peter. Then Peter remembered what the Lord had spoken to him. "The rooster will crow today," Jesus had said. "Before it does, you will say three times that you don't know me." Peter went outside and he broke down and he sobbed.
You're invited to open up to hymn number 286. Remain seated. We sing O Sacred Head.
Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Is that your own idea? Jesus asked. Or did others talk to you about me? Am I a Jew? Pilate replied. It was your people and your chief priests who handed you over to me. What have you done? Jesus said, my kingdom is not part of this world. If it were, those who served me would fight. They would try to keep the Jews from arresting me. My kingdom is from another place. So you are a king then, said Pilate. Jesus said, you're right to say I am a king. In fact, that's the reason I was born. I came into the world to give witness to the truth. Everyone who is on the side of truth listens to me. What is truth? Pilate asked. Then Jesus went out again to the Jews. He said, I find no basis for any charge against him.
The shadow of irresponsibility. But the chief priests and the elders talked the crowd into asking for Barabbas and having Jesus put to death. Which of the two do you want me to set free? Asked the governor. Barabbas, they answered. Well, then what shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ? Pilate asked. And they all answered, crucify him. Well, why? What wrong has he done? Pilate asked. But they shouted even louder, crucify him. And Pilate saw that he wasn't getting anywhere. Instead, this crowd was starting to get angry. So he took water and he washed his hands in front of them. I am not guilty of this man's death, he said. You are accountable for that. And all the people answered, we and our children will accept the guilt for this death. Pilate let Barabbas go free. He had Jesus whipped, and then he handed him over to be nailed to a cross.
The shadow of mockery. The soldiers led Jesus away into the palace. And it was called the Praetorium. They called together the whole company of soldiers. The soldiers put a purple robe on Jesus. Then they twisted thorns together to make a crown. They placed it on his head. They began to call out to him, we honor you, King of the Jews. Again and again, they hit him on the head with a stick. They spit on him. They fell on their knees and pretended to honor him. After they had made fun of him, they took off the purple robe. They put his own clothes back on him. They led him out to nail him to a cross.
extinguishing the Christ candle. My God, my God, why have you deserted me? Why do you seem so far away when I need you to save me? Why do you seem to be so far away that you can't hear my groans? My God, I cry out in the daytime, but you don't answer. I cry out at night. I can't keep quiet. But you rule from your throne as the Holy One. You are the God of Israel praises. Our people of long ago put their trust in you. They trusted in you, and you saved them. They cried out to you, and were saved. They trusted in you, and you didn't let them down. People treat me like a worm and not a man. They hate me and look down on me. All those who see me laugh at me. They shout at me and make fun of me. They shake their heads at me. They say, he trusts in the Lord. Let the Lord help him. If the Lord is pleased with him, let him save him. But you brought me out of my mother's body. You made me trust in you, even when I was at my mother's breast. From the time I was born, you took care of me. Ever since I came out of my mother's body, you have been my God. Don't be far away from me. Trouble is near, and there's no one to help me. Many enemies all around me, they all are like strong bulls from the land of Bashan. They are like roaring lions that tear to pieces what they kill. They open their mouths wide to attack me. My strength is like water that is poured out on the ground. I feel as if my bones aren't connected. My heart has turned to wax. It has melted away inside me. My strength is dried up like a piece of broken pottery. My tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You bring me down to the edge of the grave. A group of sinful people has closed in on me. They are all around me like a pack of dogs. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can see all of my bones right through my skin. People stare at me. They laugh when I suffer. They divided my clothes among them. They cast lots for what I'm wearing. Lord, don't be so far away. You give me strength. Come quickly to help me. Save me from this sword. Save the only life I have. Save me from the power of those dogs. Save me from the mouths of those lions. Save me from the horns of those wild oxen.
Tradition to strip the chancel, to clear it of its sacramental items that represent Christ, tear away the tearments, that symbolize the presence and authority of Christ. For Christ has died. Christ has been laid in the tomb. Life has gone out. We sit in the darkness. It's as if hope has disappeared. Sometimes it's good to sit in the dark. Sometimes it's in the darkness that we remember what light is like, what life is like. And we begin to yearn for it yet again. Truth is, even though it is dark, even though Christ is dead, even though Christ is buried, God is still at work. On this side of history, it may be Friday, but we know Sunday is coming. For now, as we go our ways in silence, you are welcome to use your phones to find your way out if you need to. But let us go, both in the awareness of Christ's death and in the faith and hope that God is still at work. Go, my friends.